Switch monitoring is an important part of the network infrastructure monitoring. If a switch fails, the subnet can become unavailable. In the worst case, the entire network may go down. The switch parameters can be accessed and monitored using the SNMP protocol and the 10-strike network monitor program. Let's see how to do this. First, you need to add manage switches to host list in the program. Click Add Host and specify the device address, name, and type. The new switch is added to the host list. By default, the ping check is automatically assigned to the new host. You can also scan the network and add all the switches at once. Click the Scan Network button for that. Select the Scan IP Addresses option. Specify an address range your switches belong to. Specify SNMP credentials for devices in the scanning parameters, the community string, or username and password. Click Next, and the scanning will start. Select Hosts for adding to the host list. On the last step, you can specify a folder for the hosts. Click Finish to add the switches to the monitoring list. Now, create necessary checks for each switch. Select a host and click Add Check. You can find checks for switches in the Network Equipment section. Now, the program can monitor switch parameters, used ports, port statuses, control traffic, and bandwidth. Let's add the bandwidth monitoring check for one of the switch ports. Specify settings for receiving the switch data using SNMP and press the Get button to check whether the information is received. The list of available ports will be displayed. Select a necessary port. Configure the condition for the network bandwidth when the check will be considered as successfully executed. For example, the condition will be satisfied if the current bandwidth for the last 10 minutes does not exceed 80% of the port's maximum speed. On the second step, we can configure additional parameters. You can change the time interval, check dependency and priority, and prevent false alerts. You can also create several intermediate alerting levels for receiving notifications before the value of the monitored parameter exceeds the threshold. On the last step, we see the notification settings. You can send alerts to Slack, Telegram, email, or SMS. In addition, the program can execute your own script as a response to a failure. It can also send alerts to SNMP trap or syslog. For example, let's display a message on the screen. After finishing, the check appears in the monitoring list. We see the current value of the monitored parameter in the table, and when you click on it, you also see its changes on a graphic chart. When the port's bandwidth exceeds 80% of the maximum, the program generates an alert. In the same way, you can add the port monitoring check for cases when the switch interface state changes from up to down. The SNMP parameter monitoring check makes it possible to control a large list of parameters on any network device. Each parameter is identified by a numeric code called the Object ID, or OID. The codes for the same parameter may differ in different switch models. You can find them in the documentation for your device or on the internet. Let's add this check. Click SNMP parameter monitoring. Configure SNMP settings for accessing the switch data. Specify OID. To simplify this process, several templates were added to the program: the device uptime, the processor load, and free memory. You can add an MIB file for your particular switch to the program. After that, you'll be able to select parameters using the MIB browser, which displays parameter names in text form. Let's create the processor load check. An alert will be generated when the processor load exceeds 85%. Configure notifications. The monitoring check receives the current CPU usage from the switch, so you can observe it on the graph. Similarly, you can add checks for temperature, memory, or any other switch parameter available. You can add graphic indicators for parameters and observe them on the Dashboard tab. You can also monitor switches using a graphic network map, add widgets for monitored parameters, and place them next to the device icons. So you'll see the current parameters values as labels, diagrams, or gauges. Now, the switch is working fine. The temperature is normal, the traffic speed is not exceeding the limit, the processor is not loaded, and there is enough memory. The green indicator next to the device icon means that all the checks on the switch have passed successfully, and there's no reason to worry. If some of the checks fail, you'll see this right away. The host will turn yellow or red. You can find the download link for the program trial version in the video's description, and there's also a link to a more detailed text version of the review.